Hello, beautiful people. Welcome to the very first edition of AP Talks, hosted by yours truly, Alex Paleo. I'm a bio major, for anyone who doesn't know, at Duquesne University. This very first podcast is going to be basically revolving around this article I found very interesting. I'd love to talk about it with you guys. So without further ado, let's get straight into it. So the name of the article is called "Is Social Media Screen Time Really Associated with Poor Adolescent Mental Health?" So this basically follows a diary study where they basically took kids from ranging from like 13 to 17, and they basically had their screen time recorded, and they basically took that data and analyzed their mental behavior through therapy and other means. So basically, I'm very interested in this topic. Not only was it the topic I kind of umbrellaed throughout the entire semester in my science writing class, but social media in general is just a very interesting topic for me because, you know, it's an everyday thing for me. We all go online, we go check Twitter, we check Instagram, we check TikTok, we check YouTube, you name it, we check it. You know, we go for our content, we go for an escape. But, you know, sometimes I will, you know, I can confide for this. Like, sometimes being on social media is a big hindrance on my mental health. And, you know, it can be a distraction sometimes in my school life. So, you know, in this Journal of Affective Disorders, they really hone in on the study and what exactly they did. The people that did the study were Amber Barthorpe, Lizzie Winstone, Becky Mars, and Paul Moran. So kudos to them for really taking their time with this study and really taking time out of their, you know, research and to put out such amazing work for our scientific community. Okay, so for today's episode, I was able to get in touch with two of my colleagues from back home, and they are very opinionated on this topic, and I would love to get their perspectives. So my first guest, her name is Palak. She goes to Georgia Tech. She's a junior. She's a biomedical engineer major, and I have been friends with her since junior year of high school. And she's done a lot with like TED Talks, and I know she has a big opinion on social media and how we interact as a society. So here's that conversation.
Hi, Alex. Thank you so much for having me.
Oh, thank you so much for being on the show. Of course, my first guest. So I wanted to talk to you about the major results that I found within this article. So the biggest result is that there's a huge correlation between screen time and self-harm/depression/self-esteem issues with our generation. What is your opinion on it?
Yeah, so those results definitely make sense to me. We're constantly fed a negative visual diet through social media, television, and other marketing methods. And nowadays, we're all so obsessed with posting the perfect picture and making sure we use all the editing apps and Photoshop to post the best versions of ourselves for others to see. So we ourselves are contributing to this negative visual diet and overall are promoting poor mental health. I mean, we compare ourselves to what we see on these social media platforms, and this comparison is what is the root of the problem. We're thrown into the cycle of seeing these negative promoting visuals, and I mean, this is just what we see scrolling through our phone every day. And the more we're on our social media, and the more we're on our phone, the less time we're outside getting oxygen and, you know, doing physical activity or even getting sleep. So these results really make sense to me.
Yeah. I mean, even from our personal experience, I know, like, we tend to always, like, oh, what are we going to post? Oh, what picture should we put first? Oh, what caption should we put? Like, we've spent
gotta
hours.
Gotta be the perfect caption, yeah.
Yeah. So, like, I mean, especially with our generation and the way we've grown up into this society of, like, having that perfect body look, you know, aesthetic, mm-hmm. You know, it's just, It's crazy. And
It
like
is.
with the researchers with this article, they're saying they want to expand just from not only just screen time, but they want to expand into like how we edit our pictures, our group chats, what we watch on YouTube. How do you feel about like that invasion of privacy?
I mean, to me, obviously, it's a big invasion of privacy. I don't want my personal text messages being read or things like that. But at the same time, it's already happening. Everything we do in the digital space is already recorded and being analyzed and, put into the algorithm for us. So it's already happening, whether we like it or not. But that doesn't mean it should continue to happen. So I'm definitely not a fan of this idea.
Well, do you think this will even help with trying to prevent like poor mental health?
Well, I don't think so, because what are they going to do with this data? Like, have they said what they're going to do with, after gathering the data of us editing photos? What are they planning to do with the data?
Well, it seems like they're going to see if our actions are positive or negative and then determine from there what the rate of self-harm would be, I would assume.
See, I just don't think that's helpful, because I mean, we're not editing the anytime you're editing yourself to make yourself seem more perfect in your eyes, that's gonna promote poor mental health, because that basically puts you like that in your viewpoint. You're looking at yourself as, you have flaws and you have mistakes that you want to fix, and these apps are fixing it for you. So whenever that happens, it's going to promote poor mental health. So either way, I don't think you need research to tell you that editing is going to be in the negative direction.
Yeah, I totally agree with that. Well,
Yeah.
thank you so much for being on the podcast.
It was my pleasure. Thank you for having me.
Yeah. All right, I'll talk to you soon.
Yep, bye-bye.
Bye.
Okay, now we have our second guest. Her name is Sam. She goes to Duquesne with me and with all of us. And she's a PT major, and she's a senior this year. And I know she's very opinionated on this, so I'm gonna just go straight to that conversation.
Hey Alex, thanks for having me.
Hey Sam, what's going on?
Nothing much. What's up?
All right, so I wanted to get your opinion on this result of this article that I found recently. So
Okay.
basically, it's all about social media and mental health, which I know you are a huge advocate for. So
Yep.
they found that there's a huge correlation between high amounts of screen time and self-harm slash depression and self-esteem within our generation. So what's your opinion on it?
I mean, I'm not surprised by it. I can personally attest to that. I know I struggle with mental illness, and I've noticed a high correlation between my increased screen time and like my mental illness is acting up. So I'm really not surprised by it, especially because our whole generation is surrounded by all of this social media, and a lot of people tend to have like very negative perceptions of social media. And it's not very often used as like a positive way of communicating. It's usually something to like show off your life and show off how good your life is compared to others. So I'm really not surprised.
Yeah, I'm not surprised either, just because like we kind of grew up in this world of like wanting that validation, wanting that perfect image, that aesthetic that everyone's yearning for, you know? It's just like
Yeah.
with the whole Instagram like wave, it's just, you know, everyone's trying to have that perfect caption, having the amount of likes. Like, I mean, you and I have gone through that, and like, oh my goodness, what's gonna be the first picture that I post, or what's gonna be the caption, you know?
Yeah, the number of times we've sat in your living room just trying to come up with a caption for a stupid Instagram post, or the number of times we're like, okay, we have to post it at this specific time to get this amount of likes.
Yeah.
And we always post the things that make our lives look so much better than they actually are. So, yeah, it's just how it is, I guess.
Now, they're also looking into like what the future is going to look like for this study, and they're looking just like beyond screen time. They're looking at seeing like how we edit our pictures, who we're texting in our group chats, the content we like watch on YouTube, and like reading things on Twitter. Like, how do you feel about like that invasion of privacy, even though it's like already kind of happening?
Well, I think that, especially with like YouTube and stuff like that, a lot of people find humor in negative things that happen to them. So if you have a bad day and you rant about it, that's funny. That's what makes people laugh. So that's, it tends to produce a lot of negative content. So I am guessing that they're going to find the same correlation as they did with the high amounts of screen time, is that mental illness or like self-harm or whatever else they were looking at, it's going to be higher with the increased amount of like YouTube usage or anything else in that realm.
Do you think like they'll be able to find that correlation of like destructive behavior? Like, I don't know if they're going to be able to find it from like people editing their pictures.
I think it might depend on how they edit their pictures per se. Like, I know we have Facetune and Bodytune, so if they're editing it using like teeth whitening, then you know that's something that everyone does. Like, everyone wants whiter teeth. But if they're editing their pictures to make themselves look a certain body type, I think that is kind of harmful, especially for teenagers who are going through all these different changes physically and mentally, that I think it's just going to be an overwhelming negative thing that they're going to find, especially with picture editing. Like, yeah, it's one thing to edit the colors or the brightness, but then you have these apps like Facetune where people can literally change how they look. And I think that's a big factor in body dysmorphia, especially.
Yeah, no, I totally agree with that. Well, thank you for bringing your awesome opinion to this podcast. I really appreciate it.
Of course, I'd love to help.
All right, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
So yeah, to wrap this whole conversation up, I really first want to thank Sam and Palak for coming on and for giving us their perspective on this whole situation. I know personally for me, social media is a big topic that I love covering, I love talking about. So for them to come on, it's a really special time and a special way of portraying this this information. So without further ado, thank you for listening to the very first podcast of AP Talks. Who knows, this might turn into something, but I don't know. We'll see. But thank you for listening. I would like to thank my special guests yet again. And that's it. Thanks for listening.